find Brahms in 1877 in Würthersee in Austria, in his ritual, in his daily ritual of walking in nature. To have this routine that actually brought him joy and happiness resulted then in this second symphony. Is it really that happy? The first statement in the symphony is Pierori. It's not as simple, oh, we are in D major, it's happy. No, it's a D major, but with a question mark immediately brought on. And then you have the beautiful melody you have in the winds, in the horns, but we always come back and he returns to the timpani and he returns to the trombones that always provide this darkness. Then he takes this motif and turns this three-note question mark, basically, into a musical motif that becomes the most serene, beautiful melody. The same notes that are manipulated, one's going down, one's coming up, and they have completely different meanings. Then, of course, we arrive to the cello melody. This one is full of questions and a little bit of darkness behind it. In the coda, you hear the oboe. On this last note of tim pam pam, he brings in the solo horn. I always associate the solo horn melody that Brahms writes to his own voice, and he says, this is me, this is Brahms. From this point on, Brahms writes slower in the tempo. The theme that at the beginning was happy, because of the manipulation of the tempo, becomes melancholic. And this is exactly what Brahms is trying to say. Something that you look with pleasure in the back, in time, the next time when you see it, in retrospect, it's melancholy. The third movement, the most light and beautiful in the way that it makes us feel like there is no worry in the world. The fourth movement begins in some of the most mysterious way. And then all of a sudden, just when you think this is going to be very, very soft, then it explodes. I think Brahms is telling us that this is actually a moment that is really, truly happy in his life. Yes. There is always that underlying melancholy, that underlying darkness that we all have in our lives. But actually, it's our choice to create happiness in our lives, and the way that we transform and we look at beauty and we accept it in our life, this is what gives life happiness and meaning. And Brahms shows us this exact same thing in the end of the symphony.